What's up guys, in today's video I want to talk about how I spend my time as a high school student and as a beginning YouTuber. I think that a lot of people underestimate the time you need to spend on YouTube, but there are also a lot of people that I think are overestimating the time you need to spend on it. And of course, if you want to truly get better at it the fastest you can, that is obviously helpful if you spend more and more time on it, but it isn't always necessary to edit a video for 5, 6, 7, 8 hours if you just want to get out of content and just practice creating YouTube videos. As of right now, there are 4 categories that take up the most of my time. One being school, as in the classes itself. 2 being homework. 3 being studying. And 4 being YouTube. So like 3 out of 4 are for school purposes. And it costs quite a lot of time. And today I wanted to break it all down for you. So if you want to start your own channel, you can kind of know what to expect. Right now, with everything going on in the world, my daily school schedule has changed quite a lot. Usually I had school from 8:30 a.m. to either 2:20 p.m. or 3:10 p.m. Right now my schedule is usually around 9 a.m. till 1 p.m. So on average I have 4 hours a day. That obviously plays quite a big part in how much time I have. I mean, go to school for 4 hours or like, let's say 6 hours. I mean, it gives you extra time, which is quite nice. On the other hand, I would much rather have normal school because I really miss my friends and just the interaction in the classroom. Right now, I would estimate that I spend 30 to 60 minutes on average on homework and just assignments. Sometimes it's a bit more, usually it's more around the 30 minute mark. When I had normal school, this was a little bit higher. And for studying, I don't have an exam week coming up for quite a few weeks, but I have started studying, I think 3 weeks ago already, because I'm the type of person that likes to prepare weeks up front so that I have just consistent small workload instead of having to study my ass off for like the week or 2 weeks before the exam. So yeah, right now if I want to study a certain paragraph for history or geography, which I explained how I study in this video here, over here, the only thing I need to do is repeat it, and I spend like 2 to 5 minutes per paragraph. So yeah, that's really easy. For other subjects, I spend quite a bit more time because I haven't found a way to study as effective as I did for information sensitive subjects. Subjects like geography, history, philosophy. Not that I have philosophy, but yeah. So yeah, studying wise, I don't have to spend a lot of time on that as of now, because I decided I wanted to do many small things in the long run instead of a few really big things on short term. And then we have YouTube. Right now I post 1 video a week, and I post every Thursday on 5 p.m. I don't know exactly how my time zone is called, but it's GMT plus 2. And I have to say that as of right now, I don't spend a whole lot of time on it. Usually I spend like 30 minutes to an hour filming, and 2 to 3 sometimes, now 2 to 4 hours editing. But I do want to say that in the future I'm going to put a lot more effort in my videos, and it will require a lot more planning. So I will definitely have to start considering that more when I think about how I'm going to spend my time. Because certainly since being home like all the time, I always have wasted hours upon hours on YouTube. And yes, usually I use YouTube as a platform to learn new things, and I've certainly done that as well. But there's also way too many hours spent on just I don't know, seeing stuff fall off a tower on a trampoline or something that it's maybe fun to watch, but doesn't really contribute anything to my life. So yeah, I want to dial that back a little bit and just use that extra time to spend it on improving my YouTube video and my channel and maybe social media stuff, because that, surprisingly for a 17-year-old, is not my strong suit. I'm wildly inconsistent with social media and stuff. Right now I also spend an average of, I know it's way too few, I don't like 3 hours per week on exercising, and that's usually just playing soccer with my sister and my little brother. And yeah, sometimes I go for a hike because we live like 5 minutes away from the hedge, and I have tried to get into running, but right now I don't know what exactly is going on, but whenever I run, my shins just hurt like hell. I don't think they're, it's shin splints, but I don't really know what it is. But yeah, I'm gonna have to try to figure out a way to work around that, because I do like running. I mean, my conditioning is horrible after years of doing very little. If you want to know why, check out my video on why physical activities are hard for me, somewhere up here. So yeah, I want to increase this time I spend on exercising as well. So in conclusion, I want to decrease the time I spend on YouTube and stuff. I don't really have to cut back on social media time other than YouTube, or time spent on my phone, since, as I said, other than YouTube, I don't really do that much. Usually these days my screen time on just my phone is like 5-6 hours, but like 90% of that is YouTube and 10% is something else. And sometimes it's a bit more because I also read on my phone sometimes, so yeah, but I don't count that as time I would have to cut back on. So if I look at the time I spend per day on school, in the worst case scenario, it's like right now 4 hours of lessons, sometimes five, usually not. It's tops 1 hour of homework and tops 30 minutes of studying. So as of right now, I at the absolute most spend 5.5 hours in school per day, which is not a lot. And yeah, YouTube isn't really something I can estimate a time per day, because I have a film day, an edit day, and then just whatever day I decide to publish it and whatever day I decide to upload it to YouTube. Sometimes I edit a video on Wednesday, so I can only upload it on Thursday, which is a few hours usually before it would have to go live. And sometimes I do finish early and I already upload it to YouTube and put it in the planning mode on like Wednesday or Tuesday. But that doesn't really cost that much time. It's, I would say, an average that costs around 30 minutes, including writing the description, putting all the YouTube cards in, and the end screen and all that stuff. So that isn't too much. So you could say that from the 168 hours in a week, I spend an average of 20 hours on just classes. I spend like 7 hours a week on homework and 3 to 4 hours a week on studying. And this is in the most ambitious scenario. And in addition to that, I'd spend like 1 hour a week filming a YouTube video, which is going to increase this coming period. And I spend, let's say, 4 hours tops on editing. Oh, and then we have the like 3 to 4 hours of exercise related things. So in total, I spend around 40 hours a week on school, exercise, YouTube related things. Yeah, I usually go to bed by 10 p.m. and I wake up at 6. So yeah, that's like minus 8 hours times 7 is 56. So I have another 96 hours in a week that I kind of... No, well, of course, some of it is used for eating and socializing and all that stuff. But I have quite an extra few hours that I could try to optimize and I think that sometimes it's just good to create an overview like this for yourself, because it can feel like you're working really hard, and then if you add all the numbers up and subtract it from the hours you have in your week, it's like, quite a lot of time left on the table. Or sometimes the opposite is true. You think you're not working that hard, and if you count it and if you add it all up, it's like, maybe I'm doing pretty good. And sometimes you're just where you think you are. I hope this video gave you a good indication of what I spend my time on as a 17-year-old beginning YouTuber. And I hope you got something from this video. And yeah, see you next week, hopefully. And by then the idea is that the videos will be better, because I will have spent more time on it. So, see you next week, and have a nice rest of your day.